Blackstone presents Sharp Shooter by Marianne Delacourt. This book is read by Anthea Greco. To the real Smitty, with love. And to Nikki Whitehouse, my beloved sister. Chapter 1. I stared across the desk at the psychiatrist and tried not to fiddle. Betsy Waller was a school friend of my mother's whom I'd known since I was a kid. A no-nonsense type of shrink. Her office was polished floorboards and cherry veneer clean, her leather chair bigger than my bed. Certificates smothered the walls. She'd been asking me questions for nearly an hour, and by the way her forehead was now wrinkling, I could see she'd reached her verdict. Tara is nuts. Or maybe, Tara is nuts. She closed her folder, slipped her Brendan O'Keefe spectacles up onto her head, and peered at me. Tara, I will only say this once, so please heed me. You are not, as you call it, nuts. You are, however, possessed of a talent. You have an extraordinary sensitivity and overdeveloped emotional intelligence.
But how do I stop it?
I moaned. I mean, it's ruining my life. I just got sacked because of it. I can't have a normal conversation with anyone. I know when they're lying. I see auras around things. Your pen. Bets twiddled the sleek gold parka between her fingers. What about it? It's glowing orange, like you. Me? I have an orange aura. I nodded. Subtle though, like autumn leaves, not a carrot. She managed a weak smile. Well, that's a relief, but what does it mean? People transfer their stronger emotions onto their possessions sometimes. Is the pen a gift from someone you really care about? Betsy flushed and dropped the pen onto her blotter. The auras aren't just colours either, Bets. They have texture and shape. They tell me about the person, if they're happy or miserable. Hell, I think I even know when some people are going to die. Bets pursed her lips at that and did an admirable job of not looking at her hands to see if they were glowing orange. I don't normally do this, understand? She said at last. But I've known you since you were little and I've been in this game for many years. The longer I'm in it, the less convinced I am that we live in as scientifically rational a world as we'd like to think. I gave a mock gasp. You've turned New Ager. She laughed at that and slid the O'Keefes back down into their normal position on the bridge of her prominent nose. Perhaps. Silence ensued as she wrote something on a piece of paper and slid it across the desk. I know a fellow who might be able to help you. I read it aloud. Hara's Body Language Inc. I looked back at her helplessly, then read on. A body language and psychic business? That's right, dear. She bent her head back to her work. Say hello to your parents for me. Dismissed, I wandered to the door, dazed. It wasn't at all what I'd expected. A script for something, perhaps, or the 6 months of counseling my parents had urged on me and offered to pay for, but... Tara? I stopped and turned back towards her, hopefully. Yes? Don't mention this to anyone. Understand? She said, a whiff of anxiety evident beneath her professional mask. Her deep orange aura flickered too. I forced myself to smile. Sure, Bets. Good girl. I left Bets' office and drove Mona, my beloved Holden Monaro, home along Sterling Highway, past the designer furniture shops and real estate offices. I love Perth. My city is a woman with so many moods and angles, dazzling, conceited, sheltered, and sometimes downright stuffy. As I turned off the highway towards my parents' house in Eucalyptus Grove and drove along a quieter road, she felt a tad disapproving, like she was saying, "Get your act together, Tara." Since I'd been sacked from my last job, I had to move into my parents' converted garage until I could afford to rent again. Unemployed and living back at home. Loser. I parked the car on the curb outside number 25 Lilac Street and walked down the side of the house to my flat, thinking about my empty bank balance and my lack of job prospects.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.